There are several areas where AI can help optimize the knowledge management, starting with automating content creation process. It is said that usually for a service desk agent, it takes 2 to 3 hours to create a knowledge article. Now, if you give a service desk agent a day, that essentially means they can create 4 or maybe up to 5 articles a day. With GenAI, an article can be automatically created in minutes. Early large language models were focused more on text-based processing, which is confined to solving linguistic tasks. But with the new multimodal model, we are talking about even processing image, audio, video, even this interview. You can actually easily create a knowledge article from sessions like these, right? It can be done quickly within seconds or within minutes. The second aspect is personalization of knowledge. The knowledge that is presented to you is based on the context, based on the persona that the system is interacting with, and based on individual needs and preferences. The third aspect is translation. It was a daunting task for IT to manually translate knowledge article from one language to another. With GenAI-based knowledge management, this can be done in real time within minutes, making knowledge accessible to the diverse workforce that you have. Finally, streamlining the knowledge lifecycle management. I call this as the 3R, the topic that are relevant to you based on your preference, your usage, it is presented to you, and then overall managing the lifecycle, which is, you know, it gives you recommendation on articles that are not really being used, or they're articles that you can tweak so that the usage can go up. You have the ability to revise. That's the first R. The second is, if there are articles that you need to, completely replace it, it gives you such recommendation. That's the second R. And the third R is, there are articles which may not be relevant for you right now. You may have created this a year ago, 2 years ago, may not be relevant. So that's the third R. It gives you recommendation again based on that usage. So overall, streamlining the knowledge lifecycle management, it can help. Ultimately, again, the goal here is to improve the overall employee experience and relieve the burden of IT supporters from manually managing the knowledge management process. Every functionality offered by AI-powered knowledge management is keeping end users in mind. It can really analyze user behavior and preferences, and it can also provide personalized support and smart suggestions. End users expect everything to be available on their fingertips as a self-service on their channel of choice. Sometimes those channel is a user portal. Sometimes it's a mobile app. Sometimes it's a communication application such as Teams or Slack. It is critical that AI-powered knowledge management support all these channels and present the information to user in a way which user can quickly absorb. When it comes to troubleshooting, a digital assistant or a chatbot or a co-pilot, we call it as these days, can guide users based on the recommendation provided by the AI-powered knowledge article. There are scenarios where, you know, the ticket needs to be routed to an IT help desk. In those cases, an intelligent ticket routing solution that can help with quicker or faster response. Once the ticket is routed, the next level is, you know, automatically triaging the ticket and providing resolution recommendation, which can be done with the help of an AI-powered knowledge management solution. All of these really leads to faster resolution of ticket. Overall, an AI-powered knowledge management is going to support IT to scale up to the demands of everywhere work and really provide the best user experience possible for the end users. So these are the 5 steps I recommend for integrating AI into your knowledge management system. First, have to identify specific challenges and opportunities that you want to address. That is really identifying your pain points. This can be done through data gathering exercise, brainstorming session, talking to, you know, different departments, looking at your own current system, right? And then really identifying challenges and opportunities. That's number one. Number two is you got to define clear goals and expectations, or your clear goals and objective for why you wanted to integrate AI into your knowledge management system. This could be, the outcome could be, you know, increase or improve productivity, overall efficiency, or employee satisfaction experience. The third is using the or choosing the right AI tech that works for your knowledge system. I talked about, you know, introducing natural language processing, the semantic search, VectorDB, machine learning for predictive analytics, recommendations, automatic recommendations, tagging or auto categorization, introducing a chatbot that can well integrate with your knowledge article solution, knowledge management solution. And finally, a copilot, if you will, that can integrate with the knowledge management solution. All of this are going to help enhance your user interaction with the AI-powered knowledge management solution. The fourth one is the data quality, privacy, security, and access control, right? When it comes to this, you got to make sure that the data that you provide is most relevant, most accurate, and it is presented in a well-structured manner to the to AI. Right? At the same time, it, you know, since it is gathering this data from different data sources, it is important to protect sensitive information that is coming from various data sources and make sure that you are complying with the data privacy and regulations. When it comes to access control, although we are consolidating all this information in a single place, make sure that there are proper entitlement is in place so that users are able to access information that they are allowed to access. The final piece is execution. Once you have all these four steps completed, get into the execution mode, which is, I would say, start small and then look at solving a minimum sellable use case, right? I call it as MSP. Addressing a pressing pain point, pick a pressing pain point and address it. And then try that with your initial set of users as a phased rollout. Try to fail fast. If something doesn't work, iterate through this, right? And gradually expand the user base, expand it to all parts of the business. Then apply continuous monitoring, right? For collecting feedback, how things are going, is the user experience increasing, do you see improvement in productivity and overall efficiency, and then you just iterate through that process. Yeah. Yeah.